Hi, it's Katie from Katie Cooks and Crafts, and today I'm crafting, and I'm going to make some rose beads. This is a really fun and simple craft project that you can make from old roses. If you got flowers for Valentine's Day or your anniversary, you can take the rose petals and turn them into these beads and use them to make earrings or necklaces or a rosary, and you have a nice keepsake that lasts a lot longer than the flowers did. The beads themselves are really cool. They're sort of this rough, rustic texture. They're all natural and they're handmade, so each one is one of a kind and a little bit different. They have this deep burgundy color, but they have a nice sweet rose fragrance, so it's kind of a cool contrast between the rough texture and the earthy color and the floral feminine rose fragrance. So they're pretty cool beads. I have them made up here. Some of them are sort of larger round beads, some smaller ones. I did some cube-shaped beads, and this one's a little bit longer. So I was just playing around with them, but you can make them pretty much any size or shape that you want. And the beads are pretty durable. They are strong, but you have to just make sure that they don't get wet or else they could disintegrate or mildew. So I made these beads the other day, and I'm gonna make some more today. To make the beads, I'm using these dried roses. I got these roses from my husband many years ago, and I dried them at the time, and they've just been in a vase on my mantle downstairs. So they're a little bit faded and a little bit dusty, but they have a really good fragrance still. So I'm using these. If you have fresh roses, you can just take the petals and lay them out on a single layer, like on a kitchen towel, and just let them dry for a day or two, and then you could just proceed with these same instructions. The only other ingredient besides the roses is a little bit of water, so I have a little bowl of water here. And then to mix them up, I'm using this mortar and pestle. I've seen some instructions online where they do it in a blender, but I feel like you'd have to have a large amount. And I just do small amounts at a time when I get a chance to work on these, mostly during nap time. So I just do like one or two roses at a time, and the mortar and pestle works really well for that. I also have just a couple paper napkins, a toothpick, and a sewing pin. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to take the rose off the stem. So I'm just going to grab it like this and wiggle it like that. And you should pull out with this. This is like all of the reproductive parts of the flower. You don't necessarily want to have that in your beads. I don't think that it really makes that big of a difference. But if you look in there, you can see there's some in there too. So I just shake it out. If it wants to come out. Like I said, it's not that big of a deal, but might as well take it out if it's going to come out easily. And then I'm just taking the rose petals and just crushing them into my mortar and pestle. Like that. And these are nice and dry, so they're just crushing, crumbling really easily. Add one more here. So just pull it off the stem. Shake out any of those seeds or whatever they are inside there, and crushing it in the mortar and pestle. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna do is just add a little dribble of water, probably half a teaspoon, and I'm just gonna mix it around. So I'm not really grinding at this point, I'm just stirring it around and allowing the rose petals to absorb some of that water. Once the rose petals have absorbed the water, you can see that they start to sort of clump together, and at this point I'm just going to grind them up. And this takes a little bit of elbow grease, but it doesn't really take that much time. It takes probably 3 minutes of just grinding like this, and you can pound them, you can grind them, and you can do sort of this action. You just want to sort of grind them into a paste. And probably another little drizzle of water there. Okay, Okay, so after a few minutes, it has clumped together like this and it forms sort of a clay. And the longer you grind it, the smoother the texture of the clay, but it is a natural product, so it's never gonna be perfectly smooth, so. But it's holding together pretty well. The water content, you wanna make sure you're adding enough water, but not too much water. So if it was crumbling and not seeming like it wants to hold together, you could add a little bit more water. Or if when you squeeze it, like drips of water cling to your fingers, then you might have a little bit too much water. If you can see, a little bit of water comes out when I squeeze it. You can see it there on my fingers. But I don't think that this is too wet. You don't, like I said, you don't want it too dry, you don't want it too wet. So this works well for me. I'm going to just collect all of my clay here. And then from here, you can just form your beads however you like, however large or small that you like. Now, the beads will shrink as they dry, so you want to make them a little bit larger than you want the finished bead to be. And what I do is sort of divide the dough or the clay into the number of beads that I want to get so that I can make sure that they're even before I start forming them into beads. And depending on the size, you get anywhere from, like for this size, or this one, like this size bead, I think I got like 5 out of 2 roses, so I usually do 2 at a time, so the smaller beads, obviously you will get more. So I just have this divided up. I'm gonna make 6 beads out of this batch. Make sure they're nice and even. And then you wanna make sure you're kind of compressing the clay before you start to roll or it'll just crumble apart. So compress, and then I just roll lightly in the palms of my hand here like that to make them smooth. And then to put the hole in them, I start with a pin like this, and this is the same concept as drilling a pilot hole. You want something a little bit thinner and a little bit sharper to start out with so that you don't destroy the bead as you sort of make the hole. So I just stick the pin in, give it a little wiggle to sort of expand that hole. And then what I do is I take the toothpick and I put it in one side. I go in just about 3/4 of the way in and give it a twist like that. And what that does is it makes the opening of the hole nice and round and uniform. And then I go again from this side and do the same thing. If you try to press this toothpick all the way through, what will happen is you'll either split your bead in half or you'll get damage as it exits this way. So this is the way I do it. You have to make sure that your hole is sort of large, because as these shrink down, you want to make sure that the hole is still big enough for whatever you're going to string this onto. So once I have my bead finished, I'm just going to place it here on this napkin to dry. As you're working with your beads, if they seem a little bit rougher than you like, you just put a little drop of water on your finger, you can sort of smooth out any extra rough spots. Here are my finished beads, and now they just need to dry. And it just takes probably about 2 or 3 days to dry. Just depends on how much water you added to make your clay and the humidity in your house and all that. But that is what it looks like before, and then this one I made a few days ago. That's what it looks like after it's dry. So you can see it shrinks down, and it gets a little bit darker. So that's why you want to make sure that you make them a little larger than you want the finished bead, because they do shrink down. And make sure your hole is big enough. So then it shrinks down. It's big enough to lace onto whatever you're going to put them on. But I'm going to let these dry. I'm going to work on some more as I have time. I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do with these beads yet, but they were a lot of fun to make. I hope you liked this project idea and this video. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up if you did. Leave me some comments down below. I'd love to hear if you're making rose beads. I'd love to hear what you're making them into, or if you're using roses other than red or yellow, I'd love to hear how they're turning out. So leave some comments down below, and thank you so much for watching.